Oh, what is this? Watch it.
Yo, palm tree looking ass roots coming out of your head, about to use the sun's rays to create energy, motherfucker. Chlorophyll all in your skin, headaches. Lost to the fucking duck. Oh no, 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 no.
Chilling with a 13-year-old girl after texting her about getting stoned. But Mike Manzi's date is about to go up in smoke.
Oh, yeah, we've seen this before, chat. Come on.
Wasted my money 12 months already to the gaming cyclops XQCL.
You heard it right.
Yeah, we've seen this before.
New York and Connecticut's wealthiest children how to solve complicated equations.
Okay, we'll watch it, whatever.
But you might say Manji flunked basic arithmetic, because 32 plus 13 adds up to trouble.
Online, he calls good himself one.
Mike Thrilla. He's a self-employed tutor with a bachelor's degree in mathematics from a small New York college. He's obsessed with pizza, and he says he smokes marijuana often. This is the Sting House set up in Fairfield, Connecticut, an upscale town on Connecticut's Gold Coast, about 50 miles from Manhattan. The watchdog group Tetrad Corps is working with the Fairfield cops to bust adult men looking to spend time with 12 and 13-year-old children.
That's fucking weird.
Inside and outside, we've set up more than a dozen hidden cameras. And in our virtual control room, Tetrad's operatives are communicating with Manzi.
Any update on Mike?
Mike's supposed to be on his way.
These are some of the texts the 32-year-old man who calls himself Mike Thrilla sent to our decoy, who he thought was 13.
Did you blaze? You're my soulmate. Wow, you are so cute. You look way older, by the way.
But he also admits he shouldn't be talking to a 13-year-old.
Well, you're cool and cute, too. I just know I could get in trouble even talking to you, you know?
But Manzi continues texting. He later appears to become suspicious and asks the decoy to send a custom pic with his name on it. His fears that the girl isn't real are apparently quashed. The date is set, and on a crisp autumn day, Manzi arrives at the Sting House.
Hello? Hi. How are you? Is the house okay?
Yes, it's okay. Sorry, I'm being like a little...
No, it's alright. This is like weird.
Well, it's not so much that it's
how do you not think this is a setup?
Do you mind if I just like look around?
Oh, go ahead. I don't know.
What Manzi doesn't know is that I am waiting for him right behind that curtain. Mike Manzi is a math tutor. A smart guy who suspected something seemed weird in our Sting House.
You mind if I just, like, look
around? Oh, go ahead.
Go ahead.
But he never calculated that I would be the one behind the curtain.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good.
Good. Why don't you have a seat right on that stool, please?
Sure.
No, right here, sir.
No, I know.
Please, right there.
That's it. Sit, please. Okay.
I need to talk to you.
Well,
what are you doing here today?
Well, I'm here because I was slightly concerned.
Concerned about what?
Well, concerned because she's talking to people that are a lot younger, a lot older on the website.
Now, why were you so concerned about a 13-year-old girl?
Well, she's talking to other people that are obviously as me.
And how old are you?
I'm 32.
You're 32?
Yes.
So you came over to make sure she was okay?
Well, I came over just to make sure that
everything was fine.
Everything was okay. I was not.
So you were going to search the house just now to make sure what?
Well,
that's
what here. Well, I mean, I don't know. I can. She could come. She could be here with a group of people, for all I know. And she obviously was. I mean, don't you think? Don't you think that would be like a safe idea?
What was today's lesson supposed to be?
Today's lesson for
today's
me.
Today's lesson for you.
Today's lesson for me was to not. Unfortunately, really worry about other people.
Now, you're a tutor, correct?
Mm-hmm.
And who do you tutor?
I tutor these ages.
Oh,
ages.
God. Jesus.
What do you tutor them in?
Mathematics.
Mathematics.
Mm-hmm.
What about smoking marijuana?
Well, I mean, it's not really something that I try to tutor people in, but
well,
still.
It seems like it from the chat here. Well, you're cool and cute, too. I just know I could get in trouble even talking to you, you know.
Well, yes, of course, but you know, look, may I please leave?
Not
I'm
just
not...
yet. Not
okay.
Just yet, I have some more questions for you.
Will I be able to leave after your question?
Did you blaze?
Wait,
yes.
Sir?
Yes.
Wait, are you answering me or are you reading stuff?
Yes, you can leave after I ask you a couple questions.
Are you sure? Are there police outside or anything?
I'll get to that.
Please, sir, can you please just tell me? Because I really can't.
So what it looks like, Mike, is that you came here to smoke weed with a 13-year-old girl, and then whatever was going to happen was going to happen.
Yeah, but that's not entirely what was going on.
Explain it to me.
Well, I just told you. I was coming here to make sure everything was okay. Right. It really wasn't that far. I wanted to make sure obviously, like, she invited me in, and there
what
was
a hero,
just being a good Samaritan today.
Well, I was trying to a certain extent, but, like, you know, I was coming here to make sure everything was okay.
13-year-old girl.
I deal with kids all the time.
Right. Would you think that the parents of the kids you tutor would be comfortable with you coming to visit a 13-year-old girl after talking about smoking marijuana and hanging
probably
out?
Probably not.
Probably not.
You're right.
Now, you tutor
Chat,
kids.
Every episode, these guys just come in and just
first off,
farm
that
props.
Is not completely true.
I have
caps.
A couple more questions for you.
Just farm
really
notes.
I don't want to answer any more questions, and I feel...
Do you have marijuana with you?
No, I do not.
Is it in your car?
No, it is not.
Then why did you say you were going to come over here and blaze? What's the lighter for?
I smoke cigarettes. They're in my car.
Okay.
Again, you see how this looks.
I know how it looks, and I'm
sorry. A 32-year-old guy who deals with kids all the time comes over to visit a 13-year-old girl who's alone after a discussion about smoking marijuana together.
Sir, I understand this. I'm sorry.
That's you, right? Do you blaze? Did you blaze? Yes. You're my soulmate. You call it 13-year-old
so weird.
We were just talking. Come on, please.
Come on, you're 32. You got nothing else to do on a Sunday?
I'm trying to watch. I'm going to watch football.
Yeah. Here with a 13-year-old girl after you blaze. You see how this
looks. I know how it looks. I'm very sorry. May I please leave?
Math tutor Mike Manzi's number is up. He thought he was going to spend the day smoking pot with a 13-year-old girl. Instead, he's spending it with me.
What a twisted person.
There's something you need to know.
Is there cops?
There's something you need to know.
Please.
On Chris Hansen.
No, you're not. No, you're not. Yes, sir. Please let me go home, guys.
Sir, guys, it'd be best if you went out this door.
No, because I'm going to get arrested. I know what's going to happen. Sir, I really can't afford to do this. I can't. I'm really not here for any malintent. I really can't. Please do not.
But look at the chat.
I really just want to... Please let me go home, guys. I'm going to get arrested going that way. Please. No, I can't. I can't. I won't. Please.
You can't go this way.
Please, man.
You can't go this way.
Guys. Oh, this is horrible. This is horrible.
There's only one way out through the garage, where the Fairfield, Connecticut cops are waiting with a pair of handcuffs with his name on them.
This is horrible.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Turn around. Put your hands on your back.
Oh, please.
Put your hands behind your back.
Hands behind your back.
Guys, follow the instructions. Just follow the instructions, okay? Just calm down.
No,
I can't.
Relax.
Please,
relax.
I can't.
Manzi argues with the cops, and while he's not resisting arrest...
What does he think is a logical conclusion here, chat? He says, guys, I can't. Oh. Guys, back off, he can't. Let's wrap it up, boys.
Listen closely.
Boys, back to the station. He can't do it this time.
To pull out the taser.
Like, what do you think is going to happen?
Kneel down.
I'm going to get down.
Kneel down.
I'm getting down.
All right.
Hey, why in blank taser Andy?
Into the back of the unmarked car and hauled off to the police station. The only numbers this math tutor will be crunching today are how much his bail will be.
Hey, guys.
Watch this one.
Yes, Mike, we are. He takes off his jacket before posing for a mugshot. His t-shirt is a math equation. It's a t-shirt popular with graduates of MIT, the Massachusetts Institute of Technology. But he didn't go there. He got his degree from a small New York college.
All right, face the wall.
Okay, dude.
As he's booked, he
Too
bites
far,
his
man.
Fingernails.
The lace has got to come out of your shoes. Are you right-handed?
Left-handed.
And then he's fingerprinted before he decides to waive his right to remain silent and speak to detectives.
So now that you've read all this and you understand it, you're willing to talk to me about, we can talk about what happened today?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, we can.
All right.
During the interrogation with the detective, Manzi fidgets a lot. He lets out a big sigh, but it's understandable. He's on the hot seat in the ice-cold interrogation room.
I do. I understand the age difference. I
and
do.
It's important that you understand that.
I do. I understand the age difference, and that, and that's why I really was not intending on doing anything with this girl.
What'd you think when she said she was 13?
I really felt like there was definitely a position that she was putting herself in that wasn't going to be a good one.
Yeah.
And she said that her mother was coming home today.
Right.
Until about 6 o'clock. So I was gonna go there. I was gonna go hang out. And if her mother ended up, you know, coming in, I would have explained to her what was going on.
I'm not trying to defend these guys, but why don't you just get a fucking lawyer, dude, instead of doing this shit?
You know, besides that, that would have been... That's all I would have done.
Were you guys going to go out to eat or anything? I know you guys talk about food a lot in here.
We did talk a lot about food, but we didn't...
I was getting hungry, kind of, actually.
I wasn't sure. I have no idea of what was, you know...
You guys talk about weed a lot. We
spoke about that a little bit,
Were the plan to smoke and eat?
I mean... You know, I was planning on trying to, like, just, like I said, being there, making sure things were okay. I would have definitely sat down and ate.
Okay.
I would have hung out.
Thanks,
you know?
Man.
But that's pretty much it.
All right.
The detectives ask him about a text exchange with Tetrid's decoy.
Online hero boys.
He thought was a 13-year-old girl, his soulmate.
I'm going to do some yoga later, LOL.
How's your downward dog?
You remember what you said?
No, I don't, but you can.
How's your downward dog?
Well, okay, yeah, but that's a yoga move still. But
it is, but...
Yeah.
Like, come on.
I mean,
I'm a guy, you're a guy. I get it.
So you're putting this guy
a 13-year-old girl
into
some sort of danger. A 13-year-old who can't make those decisions and judgments on their own because of their age, and that's why they have the law.
Because Manzi never sent any sexual texts, he was charged only with one felony, criminal attempt to commit risk of injury to a minor. He pleaded guilty and got a suspended sentence of 3 years and was placed on probation.
Do you think he was up to more than just sharing a joint?
Guys,
you know,
see? I told you, dude. These guys never get shit in these shows.
Suspended sentence of
the only way they get something is when they literally admit black on white of something in those, like, interrogations or whatever, dude.
3 years.
They don't get shit ever.
And was placed on probation.
Do you think he was up to more than just sharing a joint?
You know, I don't know. I mean, you know, it's hard to say, but that's an example of somebody that we entrust to make our kids' and child's lives better. It happens all the time. We have baseball coaches.
That's so weird, dude. Watch this one. Okay, only watch it if you didn't see it, dude. Because listen, dude, we're not gonna... We saw this yesterday, dude. Is this not the one?
One by one, the creeps crawl out at night,
and I really
like
needed that because I had a very similar kind of cool. Said that she can ride them while getting her ass ate. You motherfucker, you better leave her alone or I'm gonna get the fucking Uzi.
Mind, even for a good price, would go on fucking TV and pose as a sexual predator, right? In a way that he cannot defend himself at all, dude. Nobody would fucking fake it. Are you fucking kidding me, dude? Nobody would. That is part two, man.
Stephen Buchanan has a date tonight.
Fuck you, dude.
13-year-old girl.
Don't make me double click.
When he tries to lure her into his car,
fuck hoes.
You say shutter. If you don't like it, you go home and I'll leave.
From our control room, I'm watching our sting suddenly take an unexpected and potentially dangerous turn. I have to stop it before it gets out of hand.
Stephen, I'm gonna need to talk to you for a minute. Please come in.
Unbelievably, Buchanan comes inside to talk. I take him into the kitchen and grill him.
Why don't you take a seat right over there? What was on the agenda tonight?
I was just gonna take her out and show her around.
Take her out and show her around where?
Fairfield. That's it.
And what exactly were you going to show her?
The beach, sites to go to.
So you're the welcome wagon here in Fairfield. You're just going to do a favor for a 13-year-old girl.
As I'm questioning Buchanan,
wait, what happened?
The defense cam shows the police getting into position, covering the exits in case he bolts.
What happened was, when my cousin came...
I replayed the donation. I replayed it. It was already played.
She did the same
I didn't
thing.
Miss it. It was already played.
When your cousin came, she did the same thing. What do you mean?
What's this? An older person
came over and showed your 13-year-old around town. And what happened in that case?
She got assaulted.
She got assaulted.
And I was in the army. And I don't like people doing that.
And you decided because you're former military and still in the National Guard, right?
Yes.
What the fuck is
going
about?
To come over and show this 13-year-old girl around so she'd be safe.
Yes.
And you want me to buy that?
I'm telling you the truth, sir.
Telling the truth, the sexually charged chat proves he's lying.
And so what is all this talk back and forth between you and a girl you think is 13? You know you're going to shower with me Thursday night. What night is this? What night is this? I'm gonna pick you up and put you against the shower wall. Then I'm going to have you ride me, babe, as my hand grabs your ass and I blank your blanks. Did you send her any pictures of yourself? Then you talk about actually having sex with her and Skyping into an ex-boyfriend.
What a fucking weirdo, this guy.
Now that doesn't exactly back up your story about being the protector of Fairfield County, Connecticut, does it? I'm listening.
Dude, look at this guy. Chad, look at his hand in the back, dude. Look at this guy. He's just weird champing the whole time. He's weird champ simulator.
There's a horrible lapse in judgment.
A horrible lapse in judgment.
He's not even filming.
Help me to understand what it was that really brought you here tonight.
I haven't been the same since I deployed to Iraq.
Where were you in Iraq?
Camp Moraes.
You saw action?
Yes, sir. It was just, I don't know, I do have problems sleeping at night.
That's very common for returning. And I get that. I've never been to war, so I can't pass judgment on PTSD or any long-lasting effects. I can't.
Guys.
But I still have a difficult time connecting that to trying to sexually solicit a 13-year-old girl.
Something just goes off inside of my head.
Did you have these thoughts before you were in Iraq?
No. Never.
And how many times have you done this?
Okay.
Honestly?
Honestly.
It's my first.
Your first time?
First time. Honestly.
The problem with that, Stephen, is that you surfaced talking in a very similar way to a girl named Brittany posing as a 13-year-old. I have that chat, too.
Yes, I understand.
So I said, you just lied to me.
No.
We have Bailey and we have Brittany.
This
is Bailey tonight.
This is my first time doing it on a chat site.
And you decided to come visit Bailey tonight. Why?
Damn, dude. Keeps rolling him.
But your intent seems pretty clear from this discussion you had.
He keeps getting baited by these comments, dude.
I told her after I thought about it again, I told her we weren't going to do nothing tonight.
Your intent is...
Can I show you on?
I don't want you to reach in your pocket.
Can you reach in?
What pocket is it? Go ahead, pull it out.
And
please have some.
Don't fucking reach, dude.
I said, let's just hang out later.
I know, but you know what that sounds like to me? It sounds like somebody who's trying to create some kind of a plausible excuse. You see how this looks, right?
Yes, I know.
So what do you think should happen?
Damn, dude. He set up an advance.
To the police station.
Well, there's something else that you need to know. I'm Chris Hansen. And this is an investigation called Hansen versus Predator.
Come on.
I understand.
Come on, pull him out.
Is there anything else you want people to know?
Guys, I have to say it, okay? Hey, guys, I have to say a word about this. What is this guy gonna film that the 9 cameras aren't filming? This random guy with a hand camera, like, what the fuck is this?
I want people to know about your situation tonight.
Don't do what I did.
Don't do what I did.
Oh, if he runs out.
And I have your word on that.
I'll shake your hand.
All right, Steven, you're free to go.
POV, man.
I hope you get the help.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Do I agree? Grab your phone. You can go out the door right there.
Next, cops are about to find something chilling. Was he planning to do more than just take a girl for a ride?
She Which is, okay. That's mind-boggling, dude. Yeah, that's fucking mind-boggling, dude. Are you kidding me?
Omega lol.
Chat, but I did it, guys. In all fairness, chat.
The predator's eye.
Dude, I told you guys all the time. Oh, they really get shit. Unless the they're that stupid. Like this guy, they spill all the beans, dude. They don't get anything. So stupid to me.
Wrap it up, Hanson.
What a joke, dude.
Nothing to see here, Kappa.
What does suspended over 3 years mean? I think it means that if he serves his time well, with no trouble ever, dude, after 3 years of like actual course, I think he gets out on like probation or some shit like that, right? Is that how it works, dude? And he doesn't get the full 10 years or something. Again, chat. Intro's been long today, dude.
QC and chat.
What is this one? Is this one good?
Catch come in all shapes, all sizes, and all ages.
So if you watch this last one, I'm done.
Oh no.
But Charles Lawrence isn't looking to hook up with a 13-year-old girl. He's looking for a boy.
He says I live alone. Okay, I'm alone.
Lawrence doesn't know it, but he's the latest guy I've caught in our all-new investigative series, before. Hanson versus Predator.
We have to have just at least one more communication.
We're working this guy with the cooperation of Fairfield, Connecticut Police and Tetrad Core, an online Predator watchdog group.
So that's it. This is a good one. Why not? They didn't fuck it. We'll do it after this.
We've even placed a microphone underneath a leaf. Lawrence is well-educated and apparently very well-off. He lives in Fairfield, a jewel of Connecticut's Gold Coast. He's an accountant. He works as a commercial real estate broker. And get this, he lives only 2,000 feet away from our sting house, a quarter mile he probably wishes he never traveled.
Hopefully Lori can get this guy back on the feed. I don't care what she says.
Lori from Tetrad is texting Lawrence as our on-site decoy looks on. On social media, Lawrence calls himself an 8x6 guy. The decoy clearly tells Lawrence his age.
How old are you?
Swear you won't report me?
Of course not.
13.
But when the decoy reveals his supposed age, Lawrence immediately follows up with what seems to be
Wait a minute, chat. Isn't that like a problem? If like the site has like certain age requirements or whatever, dude? This makes the case weaker,
of course
right?
Not.
13.
This makes the case weaker.
When the decoy reveals his supposed age, Lawrence immediately follows up with what seems to be either concern or some unrecognized intuition.
Are you a cop or involved in law enforcement?
LOL. Really?
Gotta be careful.
Yeah, man, I get it.
The conversation quickly becomes sexually charged.
I had sex with my ex-girlfriend, nothing with a guy.
Explain?
Gotcha.
Because these chat rooms sometimes, like these are texts, but they're not really like a, they use like a dating site or whatever. And those are like 18 plus whatever, right? So if the site policies are like to be like 18 and over, this makes the case weaker. I could be wrong though.
You guys better now?
Never
tried. I know because we watched all of those episodes before.
It's really awkward.
Maybe you need a good teacher.
Yeah, you know one?
You're talking to him, LOL.
So she says you won't report.
Then the lesson turns even naughtier as Lawrence talks to our decoy about hardcore gay porn.
Do you watch porn?
Yeah.
What do you like to watch?
Yeah, what do you like?
Mostly gay porn and some bi porn.
But the exchange gets so graphic, we can't reveal the remaining text. Finally, Lawrence arrives, and the sting is on.
How you doing?
You?
Good. Come in.
The light's on.
I know, it's getting dark out. It's supposed to rain, it's hurricane. You want something to eat?
No,
I know. You can take a seat. Well, you want a drink? You want some water?
Yeah, great.
You want water?
Yeah.
Did you say lights on?
How's your day been so far?
Good.
Yeah. There you go.
Some water, dog.
So did you bring anything?
Oh, I have it in the car.
You have it in the car?
But before he can retrieve something from his car, Lawrence is about to get a big surprise.
No, Chris.
And if he thinks he's in for a shock, so am I.
What are you doing here?
Something strikes me. It looks familiar.
And what cops say they found in his car that will turn your stomach. Charles Lawrence is a well-to-do real estate broker in the Connecticut suburbs.
How you doing?
You?
Good.
Come in.
He believes he's come to this house to meet a 13-year-old boy after exchanging salacious text messages like these.
Just got out of the shower.
How was your shower? About to do the same.
Hot and wet, LOL.
And hopefully soapy, LOL.
But for this agent, there is no open house. And LOL. His best sales pitch is about to strike out. I've caught more than 300 predators in the last decade, and some of them even know me from TV.
No, Chris. What are you doing?
But this is the first time I've caught anyone who I know. The second Charles Lawrence walked in the door, I thought, I swear I know this guy from somewhere. Now, I'm watching from the monitor in the other room as he walks in, and something strikes me. He looks familiar, but I couldn't put my finger on it. And it dawns on me that this was a fellow I had met on the commuter train years ago. Knew his name. He was in real estate. And here he is in our kitchen trying to hook up with a 13-year-old boy. When Lawrence sees me, he bolts, gripped in sheer panic.
What are you doing here?
Chris, please.
I know, but you'd have to explain this.
All right.
Come here, man.
He runs out the door.
No content. No, don't go,
now,
man.
The man I know from the train is about to be derailed. The Fairfield cops nab him in the driveway. They slap the cuffs on him and take him into the garage.
Do you have any weapons on?
No.
Anything that's gonna hurt us?
No.
Any
needles?
No.
He's put into the back seat of an unmarked car and taken to police headquarters. At the station, he tries to hide his face with a hoodie, but there's no escape from our cameras.
Chris Hansen hates that.
The Fairfield police chief gave us rare access in the back rooms of the station, so you can see the booking process up close.
Anything you say or statements you make may be used against you.
Lawrence empties his pockets and cops frisk him. They take his mugshot. He's fingerprinted, and he gives his consent to allow cops to search his SUV.
Want me to, I'll do this side?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay. Cops find cigarettes, condoms, and a gay porn video called Seattle Bareback Boys. Lawrence is taken into the interrogation room. He signs away his right to remain silent.
You know, I mean, Chris Hansen is actually, I know him, he's a friend of mine. I commuted on the train for years. And that's more of an embarrassment than anything. I've seen Chris's show before, so I understand you've seen Chris's show before. Yeah. Unfortunately, this is the way this has played out.
No, Chris.
When you meet Chris Hansen in the kitchen, there's no way. Is it your understanding you were going there to see and talk to a 13-year-old?
No.
No, okay. Well, that's kind of why... That's kind of my
intention at all. I would never do that.
But the detective tells him he had to know he was doing something wrong.
There would be no reason for you to ask this then.
Right.
Are you a cop or involved in law enforcement? They respond back, laugh out loud, really? Mm. And you write back, gotta be careful.
Right. I would never.
They write back, yeah, man, I get it.
Hello, well.
So the problem you're gonna have with your explanation is, if you thought legitimately that the person was 18, and you thought that you read the number 18, at that point, from what you just said in your mind, you're really alleviated of any concerns about dealing with a minor or anything like that.
Not true, because, again, people could say they're 18, and they're not.
But you didn't say that. You just asked, after finding out, after the age was written, which was 13, you're claiming 18.
Right,
after that number was written...
Yeah.
You move forward with some other back and forth, which I can read. I'm looking to get away from that.
Okay.
But then you clearly write.
But
are you law enforcement or a cop?
I do that with everybody because I don't understand why I'd be in trouble with anybody.
I don't understand why you would write that or be concerned about that if in fact you thought you read the number 18.
13, I would have shut it right down. I would have blocked him right then and there.
Oh, thank you.
Charles Lawrence is old enough to be this kid's grandfather. Yet he exchanged some raunchy text messages offering to teach the young boy about sex.
I had sex with my ex-girlfriend, nothing with a guy.
Gotcha. But you like guys better now?
Never tried it, but being with my girlfriend was really awkward.
Maybe you need a good teacher.
Yeah, you know one?
You're talking to him, LOL. School is in session.
And you won't believe his explanation for trying to hook up with a 13-year-old. He blames it all on his eyesight.
I thought he was 18.
Okay.
Okay, and so you thought you were meeting an 18-year-old. My eye got scratched, so I can't wear my contacts, so I'm wearing these glasses. And I was downstairs having a cup of coffee, and my glasses were upstairs. And I'm looking. I thought he said 18. I swear to God, I would never, ever in my entire life meet a 13-year-old.
I'm done. Myself.
It's disgusting.
Okay.
All right, that's what is this story, dude?
Consenting adults, a different story. I can show you.
I was
at my ophthalmologist yesterday, an eye doctor, that I have a scratch on my eye as to why I'm wearing these glasses and why I didn't see that correctly.
I can show you if you want to see. It says 13.
I can't even read that.
Okay.
I thought it said 18.
It says 13.
Okay.
And that's fine.
Some people just say they're 18 and they're not.
The detective's not buying it and explains the charges.
The charges are criminal attempt to commit risk of injury to a minor, criminal attempt to commit sexual assault in the second degree, and enticing a minor.
The bail is set at $75,000. Lawrence decides not to fight the charges. He pleads guilty. When Crime Watch Daily went to his sentencing at the Fairfield County Court, Lawrence entered through the employee entrance in order to avoid our cameras. Inside, he reportedly told the judge, "I am not a pedophile. I use poor judgment, but I have never seen, used, or downloaded child pornography in my life."
Sure.
He got 8 years, suspended after serving 2 years in prison, and he has to register as a sex offender when he's released. That tough sentence is just fine with Fairfield Police Chief Gary McNamara, who is working hard to keep predators out of his city.
That's a pretty stiff sentence for a first-time offender.
Well, yeah. Well, some would say it's not stiff enough, Chris. Some would say it's not stiff enough. But certainly that should send the message out that we all know what the intent was, what the reason for
it. Yeah, see, that's what I'm saying too, dude.
And he's held accountable for that.
No, Chris.
We got another predator off the streets.
Guys, the intended damage and harm potential done from what he's obviously trying to do is much more than 2 years,
hard
yo.
Hard to believe it's an acquaintance of mine from the commuter train. Charles Lawrence.
How does that balance
is now
out?
Taking a one-way ride to prison.
Yeah, like, I don't know, dude. Like, the potential harm what these guys are doing is, like, potentially, like, lifelong. And then this guy gets 2 years, dude. Okay, man, sure, dude. Sounds good to me, dude. Jesus, dude. And that's after that he literally went without a lawyer, dude. Explaining that he couldn't see the age because his glasses are fucking broken. And he has a scratch in his lenses. Can you fucking believe this, dude? Fucking glasses, Andy. Chat, now one more.
They get no time because they didn't actually do anything physically. It's all based on conjecture and intent. The show stops them before they do anything that could get real charges.
Dude.
Texts aren't punished that badly.
Okay, dude. As much as you're not completely wrong,
five
dude.
5 months to go before my 2 years anniversary.
If I pull a gun out, smile, you, and I hurrah. Shoot. You and their gun isn't loaded. This is too big of an analogy. This is not why. Check analogy. Yeah, dude, I just feel like it. The only thing stopping him is that it was a debate. But otherwise, they would have done it.
13 months, you woo.
Okay.